KFI, news of the hour, on the half, and when it breaks.
I'm Phil Hewlett from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. The mother, who is accused of urging her daughter to punch an opponent during a basketball game in Garden Grove, now faces criminal charges. She could be heard on viral video telling her daughter, "You better hit her for that." And she did, hard enough to give the other girl a concussion. Now mom could get up to a year in jail if convicted. Police are looking for a man who tried to kidnap two women in Westminster. One woman says he chased her, but she was able to escape. Another says he threw her into his car, but she escaped before he got behind the wheel. There's a sign the backup at the port is easing. The number of cargo ships anchored off the coast waiting to offload cargo has dropped from 80 to just 30. Southland weather from KFI, sunny and cold today, highs from the upper 50s to low 60s. Chilly temperatures will stick around through your weekend. Right now it's 48 in Costa Mesa. San Clemente is 52, Downey 48, and in Santa Monica it is currently 47 degrees. We leave local. From the KFI 24-hour newsroom, I'm Phil Schubert.
The crash is still working in Covina. It's on the 10 eastbound at Via Verde. Everything there off to the shoulder, but watch for slowing as you approach. Headed to Atwater Village, the 2 northbound at Fletcher Drive. You've got an accident blocking the on-ramp. And if you're making your way through the Cajon Pass at this hour, heads up on the 15 southbound before Oak Hill Road, a stalled vehicle in the center divider. Some road work in Tarzana, the 101 northbound from Reseda to Valley Circle. The 2 left lanes are shut down. That's until 5 a.m. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Dave Joseph.
Contractor West is 1047781.
Sometimes when I'm hanging out with my ghetto technicians, they tell me something I never expected.
Really?
Like what? Most of our guys used to work for small companies before they came to work for us.
I can't believe you didn't know that already.
Oh, I knew that. What I didn't know is that most of them were afraid of coming to work for a big company like Ghetto. They were afraid of becoming invisible, you know, like a cog in a machine.
I was afraid, too.
So why did you come, Zach?
I came to Ghetto for the same reason as all them other guys.
I'm on pins and needles.
I came because you don't take shortcuts. Good technicians always want to work for someone who believes in doing things the right way, not the easy way.
I appreciate you saying that, Zach.
And we appreciate you giving us the time to do the job right, even after we've already quoted a price and all them extra hours coming out of your pocket.
If I didn't do things the right way, my dad would slap me on the back of my head, and he was big.
And you ain't never made none of us feel invisible either.
G-O-E-T-T-L.
We'll keep you cool, but it's hard to spell.
IQ Air wants to give you the cleanest air possible, and the affordable Autumn Series does just that.
The Autumn Desk is a revolutionary air purifier that transforms your workspace into personal clean air zones.
Unlike other air filtration systems that may take hours to purify the air, the Autumn Desk begins working immediately.
Put it right next to you while you work and create your own personal bubble of ultra-pure air.
This game-changing technology has been proven to remove 99% of all airborne pollutants.
Visit iqair.com/US to learn more. Give them a call, 800-500-4-AIR, 800-500-4247.
Well, Mom, I'm lying under the tree to remind you that I'm the gift. And now, the top 5 reasons to visit Morongo. Number 5.
On our anniversary, you get gifts. Win a different gift each day when you earn 500 points on your rewards card Monday through Friday.
Number 4.
New Year's Eve Hotel Special. Get a room and 2 tickets for our ballroom buffet for one low price. Call 888-MORONGO now.
3.
17th anniversary giveaway. You can win $1,700 cash from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. playing table games with your rewards cards December 10th.
And the number 2.
Clint Black Live, December 18th. Get your tickets now.
And the number 1 reason.
Anniversary dining deals. Tacos at Fiesta Taco, coffee from Pink Coffee, or tots from Wall Burgers are only $1.70 each December 10th.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Morongo. Good times.
Every year, our team provides food and toys for less fortunate families. Hello, my name is John Aquayan, owner of Rooter Hero Plumbing. I remember one Christmas when my dad didn't have any work, and we didn't have any money. I can still recall the look of shame on his face when my brother and I only had one present to open. I was a brat and said something I shouldn't have. To this day, I am still sorry for what I said to my dad. I was selfish, and I wish I could take it all back. So I know what it's like for some families. At Rooter Hero Plumbing, we want to make Christmas special. So all this month, we are donating a portion of every plumbing and drain cleaning service we do to families in need. Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays from our family to yours. Thank you.
Everybody needs a hero. KFI
AM 640.
And waiting for the dawn. But that was once upon a time. Now the tree is gone.
Premier Network presents Coast to Coast AM with George Norrie.
A special guest tonight, Awakening to the Fifth Dimension by Kimberly Meredith. We will take calls next hour with Kimberly, and she will do health readings for you, too. Or you could just ask her a question about the psychic realm that she has been working in for all these years now. ParanormalDay.com keeps cruising along. We went over 120,000 signed-up members. We're now heading for 121,000. We're 808 people shy of that. So just keep going and have some fun at ParanormalDate.com. And if you're over 60, we've got ParanormalDate.com/seniors. At ParanormalDate.com, you meet some most fantastic people.
Hi, I'm Tom.
Hi, I'm Jennifer. What brings you here?
Yeah, I'm here to meet someone who understands me.
How so?
Well, I'm into UFOs, ghosts, aliens, Bigfoot, conspiracy theories, the paranormal, that kind of stuff. But can't seem to find anyone who gets
it. Oh, well, nice to meet you, Tom. I gotta go.
Okay. You sure?
Very. Good luck with that.
I can't leave anyone in the house. I really can't find a website for my new business. What is one of
you? Have you thought about ParanormalDate.com?
What? Who are you?
I'm a paranormal matchmaker. And it's ParanormalDate.com. It's a website for people looking for people like them. Stuff you like, remember?
Interesting. I'll give it a try.
Well, let's try this again.
Hi, I'm Tom.
Hey, I'm Deb. Your profile on ParanormalDate.com looks very interesting. So you really saw a UFO?
Well, yeah. But not as intense as me and you.
You're an alien chasing flirt, but I kind of like it.
Wow, this ParanormalDate.com thing really works.
Maybe ParanormalDate.com is for you. People with an interest in things they hear on George's show find their match daily. So if you're looking for that special someone with an interest in UFOs, ghosts, aliens, Bigfoot, conspiracy theories, and, of course, the paranormal, come to the dating site Inspired by George Norrie. It's always free to search, and if you decide to upgrade to our amazing new features, use promo code George for a great discount. ParanormalDate.com. You are not alone. When news breaks, millions are turning to Newsmax. Get the latest on COVID, the new inflation surge, and what's really happening in Washington. And tonight at 8 p.m. Eastern, watch Grant Stinchfield. He's warning of the growing threat from China. Stinchfield is fighting for you. Find Newsmax on all the major cable systems or on streaming platforms like Amazon Fire, Samsung, Roku, Zumo, Pluto, and more. Millions are also watching the free Newsmax app on their phones. Newsmax, it's news you can trust.
Hey parents, here's some good news for America's future. Kids ages 5 to 11 are now eligible for a COVID vaccine. That means all those future CEOs and artists, world-class chefs and sports stars, the engineers and the innovators, are eligible for a vaccine that can help protect their future. And it's specifically formulated just for them. Find vaccines near you at vaccines.gov. Paid for by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
Real people, real stories.
I had acute eczema. I have tried every cream and ointment that you can imagine. It was pretty miserable. So I started taking Ottavora, and at this point, I don't want to ever be without it.
Our little dog developed this lymph problem. The chemotherapy lasted for 6 months. He started developing more lymph nodes that were swelled up. So I thought I'd just try carnivora. The lymph nodes started to go down, swelling did. Then I took him into the vet to have him checked out, and there was no signs at all inside.
My cat had issues that developed in his eyes, so my veterinarian said, you know what, let's go ahead and remove the eye. I heard the carnivora advertising. So I said, you know what, I'm going to order this product. They did all the tests. I kid you not, this product saved his eye.
Call 866-836-8735. That's 866-836-8735.
or visit carnivore.com. That's CARNIVORA.com.
Welcome back to Coast, George Norrie with you, along with Kimberly Meredith with us, her book, Awakening to the Fifth Dimension. And Kimberly, as we get into this tonight, where do people get your book, Awakening to the Fifth Dimension?
Thank you, George. The Awakening to the Fifth Dimension is out right now. It just came out 2 days ago. I'm super happy.
Perfect timing.
I know. This is the time. It's being sold everywhere right now on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, the UK, Amazon UK. So maybe the best place to go, you can go to my website, thehealingtrilogy.com, and then there's the links to all those different places to get it, or just to Amazon and Barnes & Noble and IndieBound. I don't know, I'm a new author, so I don't know how to really direct everybody, but thehealingtrilogy.com has a link to then all those different places to get it.
Great. Well, good. I hope you're very successful with it, because it's well written and it's really something. Do we all have, not quite as good as you, but have that ability to do some of these things?
You know, I really believe that it can't just be me that all of a sudden I have these NDEs, and then I had the blinking when I was a baby, and then it wakes up again like this, and then I can rub my hands together and dismiss lumps off people and do these types of things. And I do have people that come to me regularly, and their abilities are awakening more, and I do speak expos and events and classes, and people are awakening. And I feel that there's a shift going on. And in the book, I do talk about people feeling that the third dimension is sort of populating right now. People want to move out of it. And the fourth and fifth dimension and beyond is really more comfortable for us. And when you say about our intuitive abilities and awakening, I really do feel that my guides are saying, and they're speaking through me right now, that they're blinking. This is so cool, and it is going to happen, and more people will be doing these things if you say yes to it.
Interesting. Now, the fifth dimension, how easy is it for anybody to access that?
I feel that it's a daily commitment, so it's easy to access if you commit yourself to it. So, like, I do a lot of chanting and praying. You know, praying and chanting to me is the same. I do about 6 to 7 hours a day. And I have a lifestyle that I live, which is I'm in full commitment of this type of style. And in the book is broken up into three categories, I feel. And I talk about my lifestyle in it. It doesn't mean that has to be your lifestyle, but it is a certain way of living in the fifth dimension. And does it mean it opens you up to the other dimensional frequencies? Yes, it does. I feel once you get into the fifth dimension, then anything is possible and all is here for you.
Now tell us about the testing that some of these institutes have done on you.
Yes. So when they reached out to me, the guys made my decisions for me, I decided to go because I felt, many people, even Jesus people don't believe. So I felt like I should go there and do the testing. So like SciTech, Ions, and Dr. Terry did the testing on me. I was tested for water to see if I could change the effects of water. Mm-hmm. I was tested on multiple clients that Sheely, Dr. Norman Sheely, had found out all their information on their health, every single thing on people, you know, whether they had mitral valves, torn knees, to brain tumors, to cancer, and he would know all their information. I would know nothing. I would scan their bodies with my hands and eyes, and I would know every single thing, and I would write down on his sheet everything I would know to a root canal being pulled, to how many stents in them, every single thing. And then he would go over that, and then also he'd say, well, show me if you can heal them. And then I would go to their body, and the guy would tell them, do the healing. And I would just miss, a lump. And then one particular lady, he went up to her and he touched the lump. It was a lymph node, very large, they were going to operate on it. And it was there, and he felt it was hard. And then I put my hand on it, he filmed it. And Alan Stonefield was there, and he filmed it. And then I called in the Holy Spirit, and the source of God. And then I prayed on it, and she did. And I went into the fifth dimension and beyond, and we all did, and then it was completely gone.
Yes.
Does it still surprise you that we can do this? Because it is amazing.
Yes, it does, but it also, it's not me. It's not me that does it.
You're just the vehicle, aren't you?
Yes. And then Steve came over and he touched it and he said, good job.
Was he shocked?
Yes. He looked at me and said, beautiful, good. And then she put her hand around her neck and she went, it's gone. Like that.
We were really
happy and blessed. And then we took the video and then that was that. And then over and over again. We did different clients and patients. And I did the same thing at Sky Tech, and we had that on the thermography. And then I did the same thing over at Ion. And then also I do those at expos and I do them at my clients. But that was just the beginning. And then I went into doing other types of healings and things that were going on. That happened. Do they want other people to do these things? Of course. Can you talk to your organs? Of course. Can you say to your leg, if it swells, can you talk? So this is what I do with some of my sessions on Skype. We go through the routines of talking to our organs, regenerating our organs, and things like this.
That is amazing. Now, you also communicate with the dead, don't you?
Yes. The crossover readings, we do that. We do lots of sessions for that. I do events with other mediums too. But also with mine, I love to communicate with the beautiful goddess of Mary, and I love to communicate with like Sheely. We had a lot in common with that because Dr. Sheely loves the Holy One too. And I also communicate with the higher civilizations.
You mean like ETs?
I do, yeah.
How do you do that?
They just come in. They have since I was little, but they're good. They're here to help us move humanity forward.
There are no bad ETs out there?
Yes, they are. But the ones that I work with are good.
Have the bad ones come here yet?
Yes.
I knew that. Dr. David Jacobs believes that.
Yes, they have. I've been around some of the bad ones, too.
Now, when we talk about bad, Kimberly, what do they want?
Information.
Elaborate on that.
I'm not sure they're too bad. They just want some information. They just like to know things that people can do, like things like I do. They like to know how we can do these things.
Yeah, but when you say that they're bad, do you mean that in an evil sense or what?
No, I mean bad because they just want to get information. That's what I'm saying.
Well, everybody wants to get information.
Well, they want to get information in a way that I don't like the way they want to get information.
Like abductions and stuff like that?
Yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah.
Forcing people to do things they don't want to do and stuff like that?
Yeah. But it's okay. They're okay now, so that's okay.
You've talked about being a medical intuitive and the healer. Two different things or one in the same?
Nice stuff.
A medical intuitive medium healer.
It's the same because that's what guys like me to do together. So I can't ever do one without the other. I'm so glad you asked that. Because that's sometimes very confusing for others when they come to me for a session. They're like, can you do the medical intuitive and the healing? And I just want everyone to know I can't do one without the other. The guys always want me to do both together.
Have you ever had a spirit jump into you like the movie Ghost with Whoopi Goldberg, where they kind of like take over you for a moment?
I love that. That's one of my favorite movies.
It is a great movie.
I love it. So romantic. I have never been possessed, no. I love the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit protects me.
Are you religious or spiritual?
I'm spiritual. I'm half Jewish and Catholic,
mm-hmm.
but I'm holy.
If you're half Jewish and half Catholic, you're really a spiritual because you've got it on both ends of your lifestyle.
Yes.
I mean, in ancient Israel, which was Palestine at the time, that's where all of this happened, all this started. Amazing times ahead.
And I love to pray both. When I'm out about doing my events, I always pray in both. And I just love all prayer, praying and chanting.
When you say pray, what do you mean by prayer?
In the book, I have a lot of affirmations and chants, and I love oming and music. So in the fifth dimension and beyond, connecting intuitively, opening up your heart, connecting to your heart more, moving out of your mind is very important, and moving into the heart. So when you pray or you say, I am love, I am light, I am joy, I am healed, the guides are saying that's what they want us to do. They want us to be in service. And so when you're saying those beautiful prayers and you're connecting into your heart consciousness, that's what I mean. So it's sort of a quiet meditation. You're chanting, and then the spirit and the angels connect to you more.
When you're in this fifth dimension mode, Kimberly, how do you know you're there?
You know, you feel it, you connect to it, you're in the zone. Everything is in sync. Life is beautiful, it's miraculous. You're healed fast. Everything is just like you're just in the zone. It's like, let's go. It's like amazing. It's easy.
You know Danion Brinkley, he's one of the acknowledgments in your book, don't you?
Yes, I love Danion.
He's a good guy, survived three near-death experiences.
Yeah.
He's one of a kind. He truly is. Yeah. We're gonna take calls next hour with Kimberly and the healing sessions. Now, how do you do this over the phone?
It's different than when I see people, but over the phone, I will hear the guides talking to me. They'll give me messages, and I do a lot of sequence blinking. So a couple seconds will come through, and they'll start giving me messages quickly and fast through my eyes. And a lot of it will be with the numbers. And I'll also hear them speak to me about what they want me to tell you. So sometimes if you don't get exactly what I say right away, maybe it takes a couple seconds for you to understand what I say. But sometimes people might get it right away.
Have you been in situations where you're talking to people at the dinner or lunch and your eyes start blinking away?
Yes.
Do they know what's going on, or what do they say? Is there something wrong with you? What's happening?
Most of the time, I can't get away with ever having a normal lunch with anybody because when I'm there, they're like, can you tell me if something's happening with my body, or can you tell me if my boyfriend's breaking up with me, or can you tell me?
Can you control the blinking?
No, I'm always in trance, but lately, I've been getting better at it. Like with photo shoots or things happening, I can control it. Yeah, I'm getting better at that.
That's interesting. Yeah, I bet that would be a trip. You know, do your waiters just say, Miss, are you okay?
No, but it's funny, the last time I was on your show, I had some people come to the office, and they said, we wanted to make an appointment after we were on the coast to really see you're blinking and you're...
I mean, how fast are you blinking? I mean, the normal blinking is slow and methodical, and, you know, you don't even know you're blinking as a human. People don't even know you're blinking when they look at you. But are you just, like, blinking away like somebody would be waving a fan?
I have not been tested at the speed, but my eye doctor told me he's never seen anything like it before.
Really?
That it is so fast. And I scan super fast. Like, scanning ability is fast. I can go through somebody in, like, a half a minute.
Do your eyes ever get tired?
Yeah. Yeah, they do get a little tired at times. I have to wear my Swannies. I put the Swannies in the book.
What's a Swannie?
Swannies are amazing glasses. They are for kids, everybody. They tint. It's like a blue and, like, a gold. And it helps you so you don't hurt your eyes with computers. And the world should be under Swannies. Like, I feel like the markets are going to be fifth dimensional, the grocery stores, the malls. Everything should have, like, that type of OLED lighting. And they have these really cool Swannie glasses out now.
Are they big?
No, they're cool. They look like Ray-Bans.
You don't look like Mr. Peepers or anything like that.
No, my eyeglasses, if you saw them, they're Gucci, and I have the Swannie lens.
Oh, they're Gucci.
Yeah, my eyeglasses, but I made them into a Swannie lens.
They're not regular, but they're Gucci.
Yeah.
Since you've been doing this, how many people do you think you field?
I had to ask the guys.
What would you think? 100, 200, 1,000?
No, 1,000.
That's a lot of people. We'll stay with us, Kimberly. We're going to take a quick break. We're going to come back and take, as promised, phone calls, questions for Kimberly. Or if you want a healing, she'll just take a look at you over the phone, and we'll see what happens.
Find out more about tonight's guest. Log on to coasttocoastam.com.
Good investment. Want to reduce uncertainty, financial risk, and hedge inflation? Here are 8 reasons to consider NRIA's Prime Real Estate Development Fund. Steady monthly cash flow payouts with double-digit targeted returns. Solid, affordable, high-demand home and apartment assets backed. New construction built where housing is badly needed and demand booming. Substantial properties already built and selling right now supporting you. Short and long-term strategies with steady cash flow and appreciation anticipated. An industry leader with a 15-year track record of 3 million square feet built and a pipeline of $1.7 billion of new property in progress. Hedge against inflation and receive steady cash flow. Start your due diligence at NRIA.net or call 800-800-1414. That's 800-800-1414.
An offer of securities is only made by the NRIA Private Placement Memorandum. Read it first. Past performance does not guarantee future results. NRIA is a real estate development firm. Learn more at NRIA.net.
Cash offers for used cars have never been higher. And selling your car has never been easier. And it's all because of Roto. That's R-O-D-O. Not only is Roto the best place to buy a new car, but you can also sell your used car or current vehicle lease to Roto for quick payment. Roto makes the process fast, fair, and transparent. So, sell your car on the Roto app or at Roto.com. That's R-O-D-O. The fastest way to sell your used car for more cash than ever before.
As parents, we've done everything we can to keep our kids safe, happy, and healthy during this pandemic. From finding the best face masks, to making sure their hands are clean. And now we have the best tool to help keep them even safer. The most important thing we can do is vaccinate our kids to protect them against COVID-19. Vaccines have been proven safe and effective for children 5 and up. Talk to your child's doctor or visit myturn.ca.gov to find a vaccine near you. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
It's hard to keep track of everything that's going on. Luckily, that's a little hobby of ours.
KFI and KOST HD2, Los Angeles, Orange County.
Happy Friday. You made it through the week. It's time for your morning wake-up call. Here's Jennifer Jones Lee.
Good morning. Did you love the rain yesterday? Oh, I was trying to find any excuse I could not to have to go out into it. You know, after work, you have usually errands to run and stuff like that. And I tried to figure out any reason that I could not to. I can put it off till tomorrow. Oh, I don't think my package is quite ready to send. Blankets and a fire and, oh, it was great. And sunshine today. More rain is coming the first part of next week. I'll give you more details as we get through the show. So welcome to your Friday wake-up call for this December 10th. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee, and here are some of the stories that we're watching in the KFI 24-hour newsroom. Investigators with the LAPD say they've arrested six people in connection with a series of smash-and-grab robberies in South L.A. California is considering rules that would fine people for wasting water. And Alec Baldwin has posted a two-page letter on social media. It was signed by 25 crew members who say that movie set for Rust was not dangerous. 505 will talk with ABC's political director, Rick Klein. Man, it was all about the vaccine mandates this week. The Senate voted to repeal the president's vaccine mandate on private businesses with fewer than 100 employees. You even had a couple of Democrats join the Republicans in voting. And even though that vote might not impact the ban, I think what it shows is just how polarizing even a mandate on a vaccine is. We'll dig into that with Rick in just a few minutes. Let's start with some of these stories coming out of the KFI 24-hour newsroom. LA County Health Director Barbara Ferrer says she is a little worried about another winter surge of COVID-19 cases. Ferrer says the CDC estimated the county's weekly case rate is 113 cases per 100,000 people.
That reflects a jump up to a high level of transmission across the county. So we have moved from substantial transmission back to high transmission.
Ferrer says despite the Omicron variant arriving in L.A. County, the top strain remains the Delta variant. She says the bump in cases is most likely due to the Thanksgiving holiday, which is an indicator of how it might look for Christmas and New Year. Well, the LAPD says four kids and two adults have been arrested in connection with a series of smash and grabs in South L.A.
Investigators say the group of six hit at least four businesses going back to November 22nd. The retail stores are located on South Vermont Avenue, West Lawson, and West Manchester. The most recent was Wednesday night when the group hit a shoe warehouse on South Vermont. During the robbery, a pregnant employee was knocked to the floor. Her condition's unknown. Detectives say tips from the community have been a big help. And now a special task force with the CHP has been created to go after smashing grabbers. Steve Gregory, KFI News.
Well, some people on a Delta flight from Washington, D.C. to L.A. got their destination a little later than scheduled because of an unruly passenger. The guy assaulted a flight attendant and an air marshal last night. The plane made an emergency landing in Oklahoma City.
Delta 342, we've got the trucks rolled out for you on the ramp in the police drivers.
Okay, very good.
The man was arrested and taken off the plane in handcuffs. Using lots of water could soon cost you lots of money in California.
The state is considering rules that, if passed, would fine people for their excessive water use, including watering their yard within 48 hours of a storm that produced at least a quarter of an inch of rain. People would also be fined for spraying down their driveways and patios unless there was a risk to health and safety. The state could pass the rules as early as next month. The U.S. Drought Monitor shows that around 92% of the state is under a severe drought. Blake Trolley, KFI News.
California Attorney General Rob Bonta has outlined a successful operation in the city of San Bernardino, which resulted in the seizure of 92 handguns and 19 assault weapons.
We arrested 180 individuals suspected of multiple violent crimes, including assault, attempted murder, and murder.
The operation was led by the San Bernardino Police Department and began back in June. Bonta says investigators also seized hundreds of pounds of meth, cocaine, and close to $300,000 in cash. When we come back, we'll talk with ABC's political director, Rick Klein, all about the vaccine mandates in politics this week. But right now, let's take a look at your drive. Nick Pagliocchini, happy Friday to you.
Happy Friday, Jen. And it's pretty much Friday morning light for the most part as folks are making their way in and around the Southland this morning. Westbound side out of the 91, Riverside New Corona. Just kind of light and patchy for you so far from before Magnolia, 91 westbound. You'll see those delays toward about the 15. Looks like Caltrans crews were working through Corona, east and westbound along the 91, pretty much between the 241 toll road and the 15. So a smidgen of slowing here and there for you in both directions as you're waking up. I got an update on something slowing you down. Pound 250 on the cell phone. Keyword is KFI traffic. Checking your drive as you make your way through LA and Orange County. Knock on wood. Most Caltrans projects have wrapped up from the overnight and early morning hours. Looking relatively decent for your drive. KFI and the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Nick Pagliocchini.
5:06 on your wake-up call. ABC's political director, Rick Klein, joins us. Rick, good morning.
Great to be with you.
Hey, thanks. You too. Now, let's talk about the Senate voting to repeal President Biden's vaccine mandate on private businesses. And I think that it just shows even the different parties can't necessarily agree on the vaccine mandates for various companies.
Yeah, I think that's right. I think we're at a point in the pandemic where there's only so many things that you can ask people to do. And I think there's a recognition of that because you have, you know, two Democrats in this case doing all the Republicans and saying we shouldn't do this. Well, if you're going to let it pass in the House, it's not going to get passed a veto anyway from President Biden. But I still think it's a tipping point because I feel like we're increasing realization that there's only so much you can do to encourage people to get the vaccine, pair up, pick whatever combination you're going to bring. I can only go so far, and at this point, I just don't know what else can be done. I think there's kind of an air of resignation on that now to say, all right, we've done what we can, but at this point, we just have to look it out.
And you have Democratic Governor the workers and the state's problem for everybody, basically.
Exactly, and I think that's just another marking point in the same journey here. That you have to decide how you're going to keep people healthy, how you're going to make sure your kids run at school. And that's a trade-off, and that means that you have to be willing to do some things that are draw the line on places. And in this case, you've got senators are saying, look, we can't stomach the idea of losing people, first line responders, healthcare workers, teachers, because they won't get a vaccine, and that could be supported ultimately. And I just think it has to be something that enters political calculations now, because whatever you say you want to do with government, at government level, you have to have people willing to go through with it for that to matter.
And when it comes to people who will go through with it, I know we've been doing story after story about parents who don't want to vaccinate their kids in LAUSD. I think there was something like 34,000 of them. Firefighters in the city of LA who said nope to the mandate. And so that exact, situation that you're laying out, what's that happy medium of keeping people safe, giving people their jobs, giving people still their choice of freedom? It's a very tough balance for them to find.